y'all sound a little tired.
Good evening, Mr. Mack!
Hey, is that a, hey, Ahmad?
Hey.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, that sounds a little bit better. How are we doing? That's good, good, good. We're gonna start our show promptly at 6:30. The time is now 6:23. And so I try my very best to start on time. I just believe in professionalism. I want to honor your time.
Hey!
I got called everybody all night. If I call you out, Chris, wave your hand, Chris. Mr. King, where's Mr. King? Mr. King, all right, I'm calling everybody out. Y'all look great tonight. Give yourself a round of applause. Give yourself a round of applause. Elvis, hey Elvis. Y'all look really, really good tonight. We don't have any programs tonight. We ran out of all our programs last week. But what I will do, if you want a program as a souvenir, I can make sure you get one via the student. Are y'all excited about the show? We have put in about 7 months of hard work on our production. And I know Mr. King will tell you and Chris will tell you. Who else? Alicia, all the parents who've been here, and Brendan Lynn, Mr. Williams. Mr. Williams, wave your hand. Mr. Williams has been here graciously filming for us. Chris and Gordon in our sound control room. I'm just trying to honor people who you may not see to make the production happen. We have stage managers, stage hands, and give it up for our JRTC. JRTC, we have graciously agreed to be a part of our night tonight. You all will be in for a serious treat tonight. This play will make you laugh. This play will make you cry. This play will make you think. But most of all, this play will make you think about the ways in which you should reflect on the inside, which is a beautiful part of acting because we get a chance to tell a story in that moment, in that medium. Also, too, before we begin our show, we have a group of people who attended the Fairmont Heights in the 1950s and 60s who will open the show because how many of you know we haven't always been on this platform? We've come a very, very long way. Do I have any alumni in the house? Any alumni? Come on, let me make some noise, alumni. I remember days where we had to, this is way prior to me coming to Fairmont Heights, you all used to have your gym, prom in the gym, your plays in the gym. And when I got to Fairmont Heights, I changed it from the gym to the cafeteria. We built a stage in the cafeteria. And I know some people remember that we did the Titanic last year in the cafeteria. And so we're gonna come on out if y'all are ready, the alumni, if you're back there, we're gonna go ahead and get started. And they're gonna sing a song called We Have Come This Far By Faith. We're talking about a group of people who had to walk to school, whether it was raining, whether it was snowing, whether it was sleet. In our generation now, if we think it's gonna snow, we'll cancel school and we'll have snow days, but not this generation of Fairmont Heights alumni. And so we're gonna go ahead and get started. Don't they look good? Let's clap for our alumni. They look good, don't they?
Yeah!
used to come this far about saying, anybody remember the old school? Anybody remember the old school? Y'all remember the old school? I'm talking about I had to stand on my desk to teach because the water was leaking from underneath the walls. But I remember standing on my desk because I was afraid the mice was gonna come and get me. I remember the days on 1401 Knott Street. And so we're thankful, we're thankful. Look around, look around. Turn to your neighbor and say, we're not in the cafeteria no more. Oh, come on, can't hear. We're not in the cafeteria no more. I'm gonna try to look up into the ceiling. It's not leaking. This is where we are. We are at 6501 Columbia Park because we've come this far by faith. Give yourself a round of applause for being here. I want to honor Ms. Harris. Ms. Harris, wave your hand. Ms. Harris, wave your hand. She's here on tonight. I want to recognize two special people. My best friend, Dr. Marvin Carr. Stand, Dr. Marvin Carr. Stand, stand, stand. Thank you for being here on tonight. Marvin, please stand, stand. Wave, wave for people. It's my sister anywhere. My sister. Anybody else need to stand to be recognized? Stand to be recognized. Everybody just stand to be recognized if you want to be recognized. All right, yes. We're gonna go ahead and get started. I see you in the back, I see you. I may not know your name, but he knows your name. And so, we're gonna honor everybody. I want everybody to feel honored here. Thank you so much. Brittany! Is that Brittany? Oh, I'm sorry, that's not Brittany. I have a bad habit of doing that. Okay, some people, we ready? We good in the back? Okay, okay, okay. Making sure. Right before we start, I just want to go over some etiquette before we start. First of all, the proper thing to do is for me to introduce myself. My name is Dr. DeMarcus McMillan. I serve as the director of theater here at Fairmont Heights High School. I'm in my fourth year here, and I transitioned from, can I get a little bit of feedback? I transitioned from the old school to the site that we're here now. What you're about to witness is a production of, I rewrote most of The Color Purple, so when you see it, it's gonna be some scenes that you probably are not familiar with. It's because I rewrote it. It took me about 7 months to rewrite. And so, and the students have been working on it for the past 7 months as well. If you have to leave during the middle of the production, I'm getting a little feedback, Chris, in the microphones up here. If you have to leave in the middle of the production, we ask that you do so quietly. Please also silence your cell phones, and please limit flash photography or videography in the middle of the production because that will be very distracting to our actors, actresses, dancers, singers, whoever is on the stage performing, that will be very distracting to them. Also, if you purchase food out in the hallway and bring it in, we ask that you eat that quietly in the auditorium because we've had some issues where people are just crunching on whatever it is they're eating or crumbling bags. We just want to be respectful, right? We want to be respectful to the people who are sitting next to you. We want to be respectful to our professionals. Let's call them who they are and where they're going. Yes, they may be students, but in my eyes, I see them as professionals. Do we have any students sitting out in the audience with us tonight? Good. Okay, we have a lot of students in the back. Thank you. Thank you so much for coming out to support your peers. And ladies and gentlemen, we're about to begin our version of The Color Purple. Sit back and relax. Alice Walker's Pulitzer Prize-winning bestseller and Steven Spielberg's Oscar-nominated film has come to the Fairmont Heights High School stage under the direction of Dr. DeMarcus McMillan. A fresh, joyous score of jazz, ragtime, gospel, and blues, this stirring family chronicle follows the inspirational Celia as she journeys from childhood through joy and despair, anguish and hope, to discover the power of love and of life. Ladies and gentlemen, sit back and relax as the graduating class of 2018 presents my version of The Color Purple, Purple.
She she heard the news. They say she died from a broken heart. It done killed her. Then I hear that mister went to marry my Nettie. I don't like that mister. He looks like an evil man. His eyes be just a-twitching. Please don't let my sister marry mister. Please. Dear God.
I need to speak with you. Come on out here.
What's up?
Alfonso, gonna marry your daughter.
My daughter? Then why you wanna do such a thing?
Well, after my wife been run off, kids been running amok in my house. Need somebody to comb their hair, cook their food, look after them. That's why I need your net.
See, I don't know about all that. I can't give you net. But I got another daughter in mind for you.
Who's that?
She ain't as cute as Nettie though, but she do. Her name's Celia.
Celia? I ain't never even looked at Celia like that before. And I didn't even know she was your daughter.
You see, her mother might have made some ugly decisions without me, but she do.
Well, can I see this girl you talking about?
Silly! Come on down here, one of my church folks want me with you. Come on down.
Alfonso, that's a girl? Turn around, stop, arms out. Man, these arms too bony to carry something. Legs ain't good for nothing. Oh, hell no, Alfonso. This girl stink. Smell like barbecue sauce. Now bring out Nettie.
Look, you need a wife, right? She could cook, she could clean.
Well, she ain't what I want.
Don't matter what you want. It's what I'm giving you.
Nah, take her back in the house. She ugly. Now bring out Ned.
Look, let me talk to you for a second.
Dear God, looks like Mr. might get to have me. He inspected me like I'm a mule or something. All I could do was think about my sister Nettie. If this man take me, will I ever be able to see my Nettie again? Part of me glad I's going, cause I think she ain't got to. I'll show enough do it for her. You answered me. At least she ain't got to go. But I know I was gonna be the one taking her blame. Please, protect Ned. If this man take me.
Nah, I done told you, Alfonso. I don't like her. She ugly. She stank.
Look! I'm not saying it again. It's either you can take her, or you can leave.
Well, she ain't what I want.
It don't matter what you want. Hey, you can cook and clean, right?
Yes, sir.
You can take care of some little nappy head chilling, right?
Yes, sir.
Well, I do got a farm to run. You say she cook and clean, I'll take her.
You hear that? You about to marry this man. Pack your bags, say goodbye to your sister, and get out of my house.
In my house right now is my wife been run off. You ain't in here to be asking me all these stupid questions, Celia. You in here to cook and clean. You understand me?
Yes, sir.
Now get up out my face. Hey, Harpo. Harpo, where you at, boy?
Right here, Paul.
You seen new mom?
Who? That ugly woman? She ain't none of my mom. Nobody can take my mom's thing.
I'll punch you dead in your chest, boy. That's your new mom. Cause your real mom decided to run off like a little nasty whore. She's nasty. She's trifling. Maybe when you get old, you'll find yourself a good woman. Not one of these trifling little whores like your mom.
Well, where's mom?
In a place where she should not be, son. In a place where she should not be.
When she coming back?
She ain't coming back. Hell nah, she ain't never coming back. Sometimes these women get in a place in their life where they don't want to listen to nobody. They want to sleep with every man. Disrespect a man in their own house. Not mine. Not in mine. You understand me, boy?
Yeah.
Now get up out my face.
When was the last time somebody cleaned that back room?
I don't know, Celia. Probably my ex-wife, but she did what she did.
Well? What did she do?
Don't worry about what she did, Celia. Just mind me, you hear?
Well, I don't know what she did.
You want to know what she did, Celia? She disrespected me in my house. She's nasty. She's tripe. She's a floozy. You don't be like her. We gonna be all right.
That back room you speak of need mold and cleaning. It needs to be flipped inside out. Turned upside down.
Do a little bit at a time, Celia. Matter of fact, I already wrote you a list. Come in. Come on, Celia, I ain't got all day. Come on, Celia, you act like you can't read or something. Get to work!
Hey, lady, wash my clothes. Paul, you couldn't find anybody better looking than that?
Well, I was looking at a sister, but that wasn't gonna work out.
It ain't gonna work out now. She too ugly. And she still ain't my mom.
She ain't gotta be, so long as she cooking and cleaning. As a matter of fact, Celia, come on out here. Comb my daughter hair. Cause see the naps from over here. on now, sit it down. Do something with all that.
Dear God.
You're hurting me.
I don't want to be here.
Ow.
They don't want me here either.
You're hurting me. Ow.
I'm forced to be here.
You're hurting me.
Why am I here?
Ow.
Why am I here?
You're hurting me. Ow.
Why am I here?
Ow.
When was the last time somebody combed this child's hair?
I don't know, Celia. Probably my ex-wife, but she did what she did.
I believe much I miss my sister.
I'm coming to stay with you.
Nettie, Mister won't let me be happy. He won't let you live with me.
Well, why won't he let me live with you?
It's his house. Plus, it wouldn't be good for you to live there. I don't even want to be there. He makes me cook and clean and wait on him and his chillin' hand and foot. That ain't no way to live.
Well, why do you do it? You gotta learn how to fight, Philly. Stop putting up with that stuff.
But Nettie, I don't know how to fight. I don't know how to fight. All my life, people been fighting me though. All my life, people been fighting me. I'm poor, I'm black, and I'm a woman. I'm gonna be nothing in this here world.
I'm poor, I'm black, and I'm a woman, but I know how to fight.
But Nettie, you got something that I don't have. You's beautiful. You a much prettier gal than I am. But me, I'm a mutt. And I'm from the dirtiest part of the earth, and...
Nettie, stop telling yourself that, Sylvie. You hear? The power of life and death lies in the tongue. You stop speaking those lies about yourself. Those things are not true. Sylvie, you are beautiful in every way. You can't keep saying that. I won't let you. I'm coming to stay with you.
Nettie, I want you to, but Mister, he'll try to...
Don't you worry about Mister. I will live in the basement. He won't even know I'm there. I will be as quiet as a church mouse.
Okay. Come on, I'll show you around.
Time for you to go find yourself a nice woman that you can keep in control in your house. It's time for you to get up out of mine, find your own.
Are you ready for that?
Oh yes you are, boy. You're gonna be the man I raised you to be, Harpo. A strong man could keep a woman in their place and keep his own.
You think I can do that?
Yes, Harpo, you got 2 weeks.
2 weeks?
It's time to get up out of here, Harpo.
All right, Mom.
Put some bass in your voice, boy.
Hi, mister.
You ain't clean that back room like you was supposed to.
It's gonna get done.
Ain't no it's gonna get done. See, I'll put you back on that floor you keep playing with me. Now look, I'm going to the store. By the time I get back, that back room better be spotless, clean. You understand me?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Watching God.
What's that about?
a woman who had to fight for herself.
Why were they watching God?
They needed him. He is everything that they needed.
What? They went to church? I talk to God, and I don't get no answer.
Just keep talking to him. He'll answer.
You should go, Nettie. Okay. I think I hear Mister. Go.
Shug, silly.
Wow. She sure is beautiful.
Ain't she? And you know, I found a woman of my own.
Who?
Sophia.
Sophia? Oh, Miss Sophia. She a little outspoken for you, don't you think?
Yeah, but I can handle it.
Did somebody say Shug Avery? Where's the woman I love?
She at the juke joint, Paul.
Mister, I'm your wife.
No, you are not. You are my house servant to do as I say. Shug Avery is the woman I love, and the woman you ain't.
Well, Pa, let's go get her.
Let's go.
How can I go on? Nettie! Nettie! Nettie!
I'm not going to last long to listen to him disrespect you.
Nettie. I got an idea how I can be free.
What, Sally?
I want you to teach me how to read.
Yes, Sally. I want you to read. And I want to teach you. I want you to read letters, too. Just in case we ever get separated, I can write to you. So you will never be lost or without touch.
I love you, Nettie.
I love you, too, Sally.
You better go now.
Okay.
Dear God, I think I just saw the most beautiful woman that I ever did see. She was everything that I wanted to be. She had beautiful hair, eyes, teeth. Her skin was so beautiful. I like the company of women. Because I feel like they won't hurt me. Thank you, God, for making such a beautiful person. Thank you. Dear God. No one?
You better have to talk to no other man in my house, Celia.
I don't think God is a man, although he...
Shut up all that nonsense. God is a powerful man. You on that nonsense.
Hey, Paul.
I got somebody.
Celia, go fetch me some water.
Paul, I got somebody I want you to meet. Her name's Sophia. Sophia, Sophia, Sophia. Oh, I love that name. Come on in. Sophia, come on.
Y'all ain't calling for me like you own me.
I want to.
But who this trick is brought up in my house?
Huh?
I can introduce myself. My name is Miss Sophia.
Paul, this the woman I want to make my wife.
Was you pregnant or something?
Yes, I am.
And by what?
Harpo.
And how you know that?
Cause I don't spend the time digging Harry in this here town. I know this is Harpo's baby.
Harpo, get his trick about my house. I don't like him.
Paul.
She ain't what I want.
What you want? I'm not marrying you, mister. I'm marrying Harpo.
I know what you think. I can handle him.
He's not gonna handle me, but we're gonna get married.
Harpo, get up by my house. I don't like it. She nasty. It ain't cold enough.
Paul.
Harpo, get her about my house.
I love her.
Harpo, get her about my house.
He love me.
Harpo, get this trick about my house.
You know what? Harpo, I'm ready to go. So come on.
Harpo, sit down. You ain't going nowhere.
Harpo, I said I'm ready to go. So come on.
Be a man, son. Stand your ground.
Harpo, I'm ready to go, so come on.
Boy, you the man. Sit down.
Harpo, let's go.
Harpo, take that seat, boy.
Harpo, let's go.
I gotta go, Mom.
This boy about whipped as a horse back. Boy ain't got no balls. Where I done gone wrong?
Let me get my coat.
Boy, you better sit down. Come here, we gonna speak about this Miss Sophia. Nah, not on the couch. Sit in the lady's chair. Little whip self. Son. I'm not gonna last long with that nasty, disrespectful woman in my house. She's trifling. Ain't no women supposed to be that strong. Women supposed to be soft and submissive. Weak like ceiling. Supposed to do what you say. She way too independent. I don't like it and I ain't gonna put up with it. You got 2 weeks. Get up out of my house, Harpo.
2 weeks, Paul? You gonna kick me out with my unborn child?
Harpo, this ain't your house. It's my house. And I am not gonna last long with her in my house disrespecting me and my son. Now get up out of here. I don't care about no unborn baby.
Harpo, come in here and fetch me a cold
drink. Oh, hell no.
You know what, woman? You can't keep bossing a roomie around like that in front of my paw.
Harpo, who are you talking to?
You.
I'm the mother of your child, and we're about to be married. And just to let you know, we're having a baby boy. And he needs a strong father to teach him how to be a strong man.
Well, you the strong one, Sophia. You too strong.
No such thing. You know all that black women have to go through? And you have the nerve to tell me that I'm too strong? We have to carry the burden of being strong for you and everybody else. So when you see me be the woman I am today, it's because I is tough, Harpo. And I will not apologize for being strong.
You know what? The way I see it, we not gonna make it.
Yes, we are, Harpo. Cause there's no way a man and a woman should be having children if they're not married. What you need to do, Harpo, is get us about your daddy's house.
Sophia,
cause the way he talked to his wife, I'm not staying for it.
You worried about the wrong thing, Sophia.
I'm worried about my family, Harpo. You know what? You take care of this house till I come back, cause I got things to do and places to be.
Thank you.
Was that Sophia fussing?
You know it was her. She always fussing about something.
Well, what isn't she doing?
It's what she ain't doing. She not minding me like you do my pa.
What you gonna do then?
What you suppose I should do?
Beat her.
You know what? I'm glad you came back, because I need to speak to you.
Papa, we just talked, but we had the perfect understanding.
I don't think we did, Sophia.
Yes, we did.
You know what your problem is?
It's the grocery list.
You're not minding me. Are you listening to me?
You better leave me alone, Papa.
Sophia, I'm talking to you.
Don't touch me, Papa.
You know what? I got something for you. Come here. Come on.
Dear God, I didn't mean to tell Harpo to be Sophia. It happens to me all the time. I just thought that maybe this is how life is supposed to be. Then I see you make women stronger than me. Why I gotta be the one being treated like this? Why I gotta be the one being abused? My pa said not to tell nobody but God. But when I talk to you, you don't answer me. Please answer me. Please, dear God. Yeah, everyone's gone. You can come out. Nettie.
Yes?
You still got that book you've been reading? About somebody's eyes watching God?
Yes, I always keep that book with me. Here you go, I got it right here.
Can we read it?
Sure, come on. Ships at a distance has every man's wish aboard. They come up with the tide, they sail forever on the horizon. Never out of sight, never landing, until the watcher turns his eyes away in resignation. His dreams mocked to death by time. That is the life of men. Now women, forget all those things they don't want to remember, and remember everything they don't want to forget. The dream is the truth, then they act and do things accordingly. Here you go, Sam. You try.
Ships at a
distance
have every man's wish on board. But some they come in with the
tide.
For others, they sail forever.
Ever, yes.
On the horizon.
Yes, you got it, sir.
Never out of sight, never landing, until the watcher turns his eyes away in
resignation.
Resignation.
Yes.
I don't like this reading. It's too hot. It makes me tired.
You gotta keep fighting, Sammy. I want to teach you to read, just in case we ever get separated. I can write to you.
Well, I guess I got to learn how to read, because I want to write letters.
And I want you to read them.
Let's play.
Come on.
Hey sister, what you gonna do? Going down by the river, gonna play with you. Papa don't like no screw around here.
That baby God, you playing with down there.
What's wrong?
That's me.
See, who the hell you got in the house?
Hurry, pack your stuff. He's gonna kill ya. Hurry.
Celia, who the hell you done brought down to my house?
Get the rest of your things. Where is he?
What, he's sailing? I forgot my belt.
Get it. Get everything.
Yes, I got it.
Which way should we go?
You are.
y'all think so far? It took me about 7 months to write or rewrite my version of The Color Purple. How do you think about the students? Are they acting pretty good? My sister is here somewhere. Red, where are you? Red?
Right here, Martin.
Can we turn the house lights up? Wait here, my sister is here. She's here. We're gonna take about, that was act one of The Color Purple, my version of The Color Purple. We're gonna take a 10-minute intermission and we'll get started promptly at 10 minutes with act two. So did y'all enjoy it, act one?
Yeah,
really, really good. We're gonna get started with act two. Can we turn the house lights on right quick? I just want to get some feedback. Miss McCoy Hill's class, raise your hand if you're Miss McCoy Hill's class. Make sure you come by and see me to get your what you need for that class. I think it's a ticket. Make sure you come by my room and get that. Come on up, Tony. Go up the steps right here. I want to bring up a former student who remembers the old school. He is class of 2016, and he wants to talk about where we have come from. Anybody been to any of our plays at the old school? Okay, y'all remember. And one of the things that I always taught my students at the old school, it doesn't matter where you come from, it matters where you're going. And y'all can clap for that because that's an important lesson. I remember at the old school, we did some phenomenal plays. We did The Wiz, we did A Raisin in the Sun, we did Titanic. And you would have thought, and the parents would tell you, the students would tell you, you would have thought we were at the Jacobs Theater over at Broadway. That's how serious we took it, because if we're faithful over that small stage we had at 1401 Nye Street, we'll be faithful to this one at 6501. Come on your part. And so I just honestly believe that no matter, see this audience, this is what we talked about years ago, this auditorium, this theater, and so we wanna remember those days, Tony.
I'm gonna keep it brief, I'm not gonna really say a lot, but we came far by faith. I mean, we started with, like, for the Titanic, we didn't really need no water, I mean, the ceilings was leaking, so we basically had the water effect, basically. So we started from, like, the lights we had up here, we ain't really had anything. The lights was placed 1, 2, 3, and 4. We had one person that'll go to each light to direct the light, one person was on the stage. I used to be the auditorium tech, not auditorium, cafeteria tech, because I used to be the cafeteria. So I was there basically to help him out with the sound, sometimes the lights, but I couldn't do both because we had like 4 lights you gotta keep moving. I was out of breath. But anyway, like I said, we came far, I mean, this is God right here. I mean, it was time to go to school. Like you said, the water was coming up from the floor, and we had buckets placed around, but that didn't stop him and us from what we had to do. Even though we had like buckets everywhere, we still got the play done. I mean, I've been to all the plays. I'm an alumni, so I still came to support him because I was all work today. So I was glad to come by and show my man some love, you know what I'm saying? So, we came far, so I'm not gonna really say too much. This play is good. I don't know if, I told viewers, I said, I think y'all got us beat. But at the same time, like I said, everybody put the effort in, you know, our class and his class. So, I'm gonna get the mic back to him. All right, y'all
have
to enjoy this next scene of this play.
Let's give Tony a round of applause. So, throughout all the themes for The Color Purple, the next act, which is our last act, you know, we have the theme of feminism, gender roles, but what I tend to bring out in act two is the theme of spirituality. And so you see that really come to the forefront of the color purple. Can I get all of our beautiful women to stand? All of our beautiful women to please stand. If you are a beautiful woman, please stand. We want to celebrate our women. Our women, it is Women's Month. I scheduled this purposefully in between the intersection of Black history. You may be seated. In between the intersection of Black history and Women's Celebration Month, because this play is definitely dealing with the issue of gender roles and race, but spirituality, it comes forth in this next act. If we are ready in our control room, give me a thumbs up, we ready? Okay, our actors are ready, musicians, we ready? Ladies and gentlemen, sit back and relax as we present act two of my version of The Color Purple, Purple.
So why are you marrying him?
my pa. I was forced to, though. I didn't want to.
I told that Albert to make me breakfast.
Well, you should eat some, sure, because you don't sound too good.
I think I got a kiss of.
What? What you got?
I think I got, you know what? I don't even want to get into it. All I know is I made so many bad decisions, my father don't want nothing to do with me.
Well, my father wasn't the best. In fact, I think I hate him.
You know, hate's a strong word.
He ain't treat me good.
So, you got chums?
Yeah. Two of them. Dennis and Purple.
I don't see them. Where they at?
I don't know. I guess they dead.
Dead? How do you know they dead?
I don't know where they at. I haven't seen them since birth.
Now, I know you've said this before, but why you married this girl?
I'm ugly. Don't nobody want me.
I was having trouble finding some food, but they old grease in his pants going
looking. Day old grease.
Maybe 2 days old. Had some breakfast in it a few days ago. Come on, it's late.
You got 5 seconds to run before I toss that frying pan on this pillow at you. You know what?
I'm gonna do something.
Boy, I wish you lost the dad on mine. Trying to kill me.
Who is this woman?
Well, what you looking at? You never seen a beautiful woman before who yell at a man like that?
Well.
By the way, if you're on the top of the beautiful, you ain't up there.
Yes, I am. You said it when you first came. You shall be
mine! You look young and drunk. Come here, look at this mirror.
What do you see?
I see somebody with 2 minutes of work.
Don't.
Is that my leading lady I hear out there singing up a storm?
Here I am.
Celia, you know I ain't talking to you. Get up out my face. Now that sugar, though. You want to sing in the juke joint?
Y'all pay? You know I don't sing for free.
Oh, yeah. We can get you about $500.
$500? Boy, you know I don't sing for at least a grand. I need a grand.
$1,000?
Mm-hmm. That's what I said.
I don't know how we're going to get it. But we can get it. Matter of fact, I'm going to go to the juke joint tonight. Celia, go fetch the razor. I need a shave.
Let me go find this dress. Netta say she gonna write to me. But she never writes. She say only death can keep her from here. Well, I guess she dead.
You fetch that razor like I asked?
Yes, sir.
Come on, Celia, I ain't got all day now. Don't you touch that mailbox! I had it fixed. I can tell whether that somebody been messing with
it. I ain't gonna mess with you, mister.
Like that. This my house.
Where she at? I heard you got that woman in this house. She is a nasty woman, boy. She done set the population of this county to an all new high. All her babies got different daddies.
All Shug's babies got the same daddy.
You a same daddy lie. She done got at least 5 baby daddies. Her own daddy don't want nothing to do with her. And now here, she got that nasty woman disease.
Suge ain't got no diseases. And Celia, take that water back. He ain't gonna be drinking it. He's leaving soon.
Albert, this isn't your house. You don't own this house. I come and go whenever I feel like it. This is still my house. Miss Celia, my hat goes off to you. Not too many women allow their man's mistress lay up in this here house. And I'll take that cup of water, cause I'll be staying for a while. Come on, silly. Thank you.
Next time, I'll put a little bit of sugar repeated in and see how he like that.
Why does everybody feel like they can just walk up in my house?
We just had this conversation. This isn't your house.
What? This is not your house? The way you bossed everybody around in here, you would think it was your house.
And you are?
Oh, I'm Miss Sophia. Who are you?
Our father, unfortunately.
Who's our?
This little boy right here? Listen. I don't know what he got going on, but he gotta get that sugar Gabriel out of my house. She's bad news. I don't want her in this house.
I heard somebody say
my name. Ugh. Look who it is. This grumpy old man.
And speaking of the floozy.
Excuse you?
Sugar. I'm not going to sugarcoat anything. I didn't like you when my son tried to marry you. I definitely don't like you now. I can't even see why you're here.
Well, it ain't my fault your son can't resist all this. No man can resist all this.
Well, I can. I don't want to look at you without thinking I'm going to catch something.
Good. Albert, you need to get your father. I got to get ready for the juke joint.
Juke joint? Is that what hobo is? I've been hearing a lot of things about this little juke joint. What type of woman be at this juke joint?
A woman like Suge.
You want to come too?
I feel like it's time for everybody to get up, take themselves up out of my house, and head on to the juke joint.
Everybody? You can't kick nobody out of St. Joel's.
Exactly. I don't know what I went wrong with him.
You raised everything?
That boy angry.
It was hat, man, everything.
Man,
all right.
It's full of
anger.
Homo, where have you been?
What do you want now?
Homo, you gonna stop walking around here like you controlled me. See, you want an audience. And I'm about to give you one.
You know what? Can I have a moment with my wife, please?
Sure, go ahead, look at
this. I see this every day.
I believe it. Homo, I'm tired of doing this with you. I'm not gonna keep going with you.
You know what your problem is? You're not minding me like silly do my paw.
That's cause then it gets beat by Mr. You got one more time to put your hands on me.
And you got one more time to raise your voice.
I'm not raising my voice, Harpo. I'm saying things in a way that will make you listen.
You know what? We're not gonna make it.
Oh, I know. Cause I'm leaving you, Harpo.
Leave? You can't leave. I made you.
You made what?
You. You.
No, you didn't, see, Harpo. You're not even mad. We're married. We're not fooling around. And as you can see, you ain't being that much of a husband either.
It don't matter anyway.
Why?
Because I got a new girl.
You got a new what?
You heard me the first time.
See, Harper, like I said, we're married. We're not fooling around. We have children. We're not fooling around. You can't be married to me and have somebody on the side. I'm not that kind of woman. What's her name?
Squeak.
You're leaving me for a squeak? I'm leaving you, Harpo.
Hold up. Sophia, you can't leave me. I made you. I gave you a son. Sophia! Sophia! Sophia, come back! Sophia, please. You know, I didn't think she would leave me.
Who left?
Sophia.
Sophia? She not minding you? She approached me about me telling you to beat her.
What'd she say?
She say that I'm next if I keep on advising you like I do.
Sound like
her. I don't know, I just thought that me telling you to beat her would make her mind you.
I did too. If only I had a woman to mind me like you do my part, I'd be good. Say, what makes you mind my pa anyway?
My pa say, God done fix me. God done fix me to be a woman and to be submissive to men.
Belated to you. Silly, give me my coat.
Anything come for me?
Now you know ain't nothing come for you, Silly. Don't nobody even know you exist. And nobody better not be staying at my house that I don't know about.
Ain't nobody staying here but Shug Avery, mister. You know that.
Well, let's keep it that way.
Paul. I gotta tell you something.
And what's that, son?
Sophia left.
She left? Where's she done gone?
She say she leaving.
Leaving? For good?
Yeah.
Well, that is good, son. She wasn't the right woman for you, know how. She was too strong and independent.
Paul.
Women can't have upper hand. They don't know what to do with it.
I don't think you. I beat her.
You beat her?
That's why she left.
Boy, stand up. Come here. Bring it in here, boy. Come here. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. Oh, boy, what's that on your face?
What's on my face?
Boy, come here. Is that a bruise I see on your face, boy?
A bruise? This ain't no bruise, Paul.
What is it?
It's just mud. You know the mules out in the back?
Come here, boy. Now, it don't look like no mule print.
It is. It's mud.
Ain't no mud. Look, don't let me find out Miss Sophia been beating on you.
No.
No, I ain't raised no wimp.
You did it.
Hey, mister. I can throw that extra mail away.
You better not touch my mail. It ain't for you, and don't nobody write you. Matter of fact, let me read my mail right now.
What do it say, mister?
What's wrong, Paul?
Take a seat. Papa. got killed by her boyfriend, Harpo.
Why me, God? Why me?
Harpo, there's something I need to tell. Harpo, the woman that raised you was never your mother.
What?
Harpo, your real mother was always Lily.
Who's Lily?
Harpo, as soon as you was born, your mom died. The woman that raised you was your stepmother.
You been lying to me?
Ain't no lies, boy. But it's about find out the truth.
You been lying to me all my life.
Been a hell of a long day, Harpo. Hell of a long day.
How could God allow all these things to happen?
There is no God.
That's not true, Celia. You know, God just works in mysterious
ways. No! If God can allow all these things to happen to you, and to happen to me, there can't be no God.
That's not true, sir. There is a God.
I can't believe I left my shoes here. Looking for these things?
Shug? I don't think you should go to the juke joint, because you're not well enough.
I'm well.
Not well enough to go?
I'm well.
Silly. She gotta go. Everybody expecting her to be there. Right, Shug?
Mm-hmm.
Matter of fact, I think I'm gonna go too.
Well, Harpo, you sure you well enough to go to the juke joint?
Yeah.
Miss Julie, you're right. I'm not well.
What's wrong with you?
I'm a mess. All of my life I had to pretend to be somebody that I'm not. I grew up in the church, so I had to be holier than everybody else. But ever since I started singing in the clubs and when out on the streets, it feels like the church has turned their back on me. It feels like God has turned his back on me.
Tell me about it.
But you know what? One day, I'm gonna show my face back at the church.
You may write me down in history with your bitter twisted lies. You may drop me in the very dirt, but still, like dust, I'll rise. Does my sassiness upset you? Why are you beset with gloom? Cause I walk like I've got oil wells pumping in my living room? Just like moons, just like suns, with the certainty of tides, just like hope springing high, still I rise. Did you want to see me broken? Bowed head, lowered eyes, shoulders falling down like teardrops, weakened by my soulful cries. Does my sassiness and haughtiness offend you? Don't you take it off hard, cause I laugh like I've got gold mines ticking in my own backyard. You may shoot me with your words. You may cut me with your eyes. You may kill me with your hatefulness, but still, like air, I rise. Out of the huts of history's shame, I rise. Up from a past that's rooted in pain, I rise. I am a black ocean, leaping and wide, welling and swelling, I bear the tide. Leaving behind nights of terror and fear, I rise. Into a daybreak that's wondrously clear, I rise. Bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave. I am the dream and the hope of the slave. I rise. I rise. I rise!
How's everybody feeling?
Good. That's good, that's good. All right, now we got one more performance, and it's strictly for the men, so get ready. All right, please welcome Suge Avery.
Oh my-
I'm keeping my eyes on you. I bet you think I don't know nothing, but singing the blues. Oh, sister, have I got news for you? Oh, something, and I hope you think that you're something too.
Woman. It doesn't matter what you have done. Can I get an amen? Can I get an amen? There's nothing too hard for our God. He can be the help in your time of need. He can be the doctor for those who are sick. He can be the lawyer for those who are in trouble. You don't have to work too hard to get to our God. Now turn to your neighbor and say, the Lord will order my steps. should. You have to do better.
I will.
You can taste it, but you never do.
I don't want to be with God.
You can be with God. The doors of the church are always open.
What's this? Cecilia. Dear Celia, I've been anymore.
Don't go, Shug. My sister Nettie gone. God done to turn his back on me. And now you're turning your back on me. What about love, Shug?
What about love?
What about love? I thought we had love.
Thank you.
arrangements yet?
Yes. Y'all been mighty kind to me. Except that father of yours.
We ain't been kind to nobody.
I will. I just gotta pick these things and mess these first.
How long?
I'll be back.
She'll be back. She always be back.
See y'all later.
Paul, where's Silly?
I don't know why.
Sophia's in trouble.
What's she been doing?
She hit a white man. She in jail.
Tell me more about it.
So, you know the mayor? His wife, Miss Miller, walked up to her and said,
"Do you want to be my maid?"
And she was like, "Hell no." And she hit him right in the face.
Well, she should know better than hitting white people dead in their face.
Paul, you know Sophia? That's why I need Silly.
What she want Silly for?
She say Silly make her feel better.
Well, I don't know where Silly is. She was there a minute ago. Must have went upstairs or something. I don't know. I'm going to the store. I'll catch you later.
Silly! 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 What are you doing on the floor? What happened?
I need sugar.
Never mind that. I need you. Sophia's in trouble. She in jail.
Jail. What'd she do?
She hit a white man. Hello? Come on, I need you. Get something. Come on.
If I wanted to be her maid, I said, hell no.
You said, what?
Hell no. I ain't working for no white people. I ain't nobody's maid. I don't care if I'm black or woman. I ain't working in nobody's kitchen.
Well, sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do.
No, I am doing what I gotta do, even if that means sitting in this here jail.
You know, life shows us the good parts and the bad parts. That's just how life is.
My life is definitely going through it right now.
I brought you something. Got you some fried chicken, mashed potatoes, collard greens, and black eyed peas.
I'm mighty thankful, Miss Zinn. Mighty thankful.
I'm willing to stay with you. When you coming home?
I hate a white man. Probably never see the light of day again. Hope I get to see the light of anything.
It's funny how this world works. This is a messed up world.
You know, Miss Taylor, you a special person.
What makes me so special?
The way you're able to handle things. Anything that comes your way, you give me hope.
Well, I never thought you really liked me. Remember when I told Harpo to beat you? Mm-hmm.
I've forgiven you for that, Miss Taylor. But I never took my eyes off you. You got this strong demeanor about you.
Strong?
Yeah. It's like you got something living inside of you. It's like you got God living inside of you.
God?
Yeah. The love you have. God is love.
I don't know. I just feel like everything that's been taken away from me. I gotta go, Miss Sophia. I gotta cook Mr. Dinner.
Send my love. I wanna see my family again. But I think they're gonna have me working for Miss Millie.
Welcome to the life of a black woman in the South. This life is set up for us to be down under.
But we ain't gonna be under for long. Send my love to my children. Tell them I miss them.
Bye, Miss Sophia.
See you, Miss Sophia.
Celia, where you been at? I've been sitting out here waiting on you. I need a shave. Go away and get the razor ready.
Miss Sophia said that you gotta do what you gotta do. What looks like I gotta do what I gotta do. Even if that means I'm the one sitting in jail.
Come on, Celia, I've been waiting.
I'm coming! This shave ain't gonna be so perfect. You ain't gonna need another one.
Look at you. Moving like molasses. You're ugly. You're poor. You're dumb. You're built funny. I'd be better off marrying a hog. Or a dog. Or a rat. Some with some shade. Come on, Celia, get this shaving over. I got places to be. Come on now, Celia.
No!
sister Nay, she's been writing to me.
Writing? No, she can't be writing. She dead.
Miss Silly, she not dead. While I was packing, I found about 100 letters in that chest. Come on, Sam. You're gonna want to sit down. See? All these letters right here got your name on it. Come on. You're gonna want to sit down.
Dear Silly, I've been writing to you all these years, but I haven't gotten one back from you. I hope that you're okay. I have your children here in Africa. Dennis.
You're about to see is the scene that we're going to take to competition. Every year in Prince George's County, every high school and middle school and elementary school for that matter, we have to go to Laurel High School and we have to compete. And so this next scene that you're going to see, I put a very special touch and paid very close attention to it because this is the scene that we're going to take the trophy with. Honestly, we need to be all of you guys. So I don't teach the students to be cocky and arrogant, but I told them next week we're going to Laurel to go get our trophy. All right. Because this is what we do. So sit back and relax, and they're getting the set ready now. So sit back and relax for this scene.
By myself doing Sojourner Truth, Ain't I a Woman, and the poem by Maya Angelou. If you think about it, sometimes women didn't really have a voice, right? And so sometimes it was even in the well that they began to exclaim themselves. Remember Mahalia Jackson and some of those women, they got the chance to really, they actually wanted to step up and they actually got a chance to speak. So Sojourner Truth, she was one of the ones that paved the way. Harriet Tubman was one of the ones that paved the way. So we are excited that we get to really showcase women in this particular time. So we thank you so much for coming out this evening, and we really do hope that you have enjoyed yourself. Thank you so much.
Well, are you happy to be home?
Maybe.
Oh, no. Who invited this floozy?
Oh, man, won't you just let up? I am who I am. By the way, your son invited me.
You should go back to that nasty juke joint.
Paul, please, just let him know.
Please? Matter of fact, I'm married now.
Married?
Yes, married. I'd like to introduce my husband to y'all.
Hi, everyone. I'm Brady. I've heard nothing but great things about you all. But by the way, where's Vasily?
Oh, here she is.
Hi, Vasily. I've heard nothing but great things about you.
When you're going back to Memphis?
Today. And I wanted to let you know I'm taking Vasily with me.
Taking Vasily over my dead body.
Your dead body might just be the welcome that I need.
What you say?
You heard me. You a low-down dog. A low-down dirty dog. And your dead body might just be the welcome mat that I need. It's time for me to leave this place and into creation.
Cecilia, you can't talk to my boy like that.
Your boy. See, that's the problem. He's a boy. And not a man.
See, now you talking crazy, Celia.
I ain't talking crazy. You took my sister Nettie away from me. You knew that she was the only person who loved me. And you know, I got kids. And they coming home soon.
Kids? What you talking about, Celia? You know I ain't got no children.
Yes, I do. Two of them. Dennis and Purple. And I can't wait for us to get together. Cause when we do, us together gonna whoop your ass!
What you say to me?
You heard me. I can't wait for us to get together. Cause when us get together, us together gonna whoop your ass!
I'm the man in this house!
Children, they living in Africa, and they learning different languages and stuff. They getting plenty of exercise. They much better than these low down, dirty, good for nothing children you tried to raise.
Hold on, Miss Silly.
No, you hold on, Harpo. Y'all were evil children. Y'all were. Y'all made my life here living hell. Y'all treated me so bad. And you know, if you didn't try to rule over Sophia, the white people would have never got to her.
That's a lie, Silly.
You are a lie, Harpo. Y'all were rotten kids. Y'all were. But the apple does not fall far from the tree. Your daddy ain't nothing but horses crap. You ain't nothing but horses crap.
You keep talking like that, listen.
I can't ask you anything! I can't ask you anything! I didn't ask
boy Suge. Her boy Suge.
No, you're not. You're gonna stay here and cook the drink.
She wants to sing. Do you want to sing? Don't let these men dictate your dreams. Pack your stuff. Leave with Suge. Learn from me. I spent almost 30 years down under. But something's gonna change. And that change starts with me.
Now boy, you sitting at the head of this table. Gonna let this woman show off in my house. I raise you better than that.
You ain't nothing but horses crap. Did any more letters from Nettie come for me?
Letters? You been reading my mail.
No, I've been reading my mail.
You can't read.
I read better than you.
Put her out of this house.
She'll be back. She ain't got none. See, Suge got spunk. What do you got? You ain't got none. Cause you ain't nothing. You ain't nothing but a dirty little housemaid.
Until you do right by me, everything you ever think about is gonna crumble!
Don't do it, Miss Silly. Don't trade places with me. Come on, Silly.
Couldn't help but to think about my own story. Is my sister still here? Red, you still here? Okay. My sister and I, we didn't have the best of a childhood. My father walked out of our lives at a very early age. I didn't know what I was gonna do. My mom didn't know what she was gonna do. It was February, I remember the day. It was February, in the cold, my father had the lights, the water cut off. I remember days, my father was very abusive. I was standing in the living room when my father knocked out my sister's teeth, right there in front of me. But God kept his hand over me. The little boy from Pritchard, Alabama. And I learned at that very moment, at a very early age, that my purpose and my destiny isn't relegated to someone else and what they've done to me. And I want to share that same story with you. No matter what people have done to you, your purpose and destiny didn't stop. That there's still purpose and destiny over your life. And I teach that to my students. My students tell me stories about what has happened to them, and I teach them that there's still purpose and destiny over your life. I understand we teach academics in high school, we teach math and we teach science, but we can't forget to feed the spirit of our students. We can't forget to feed the spirit, because what use does all of that knowledge have if we don't know what to do with it? You can have knowledge, but you gotta have morals, you gotta have values. And so spirituality for me as an educator is important. I'm not teaching them to be a Christian, not teaching them to be Muslim, not teaching them to be Jewish. I'm just teaching them to be a human being. If you are a human being, you will experience life. You will experience trials and tribulations. But just like I teach them, you got to be able to tell the story. And so I'm not ashamed of my story. I'm not ashamed of where I come from, because I understand that everything that I have been through was a process to get to this very point in my life. That 20 years ago, when all of those things were happening to me, God knew that I would be standing right here sharing my story, and that I would be able to touch my students' lives. And I hope that each and every one of you have been touched by this story. How many have been touched? This has been a blessing to my life, and I hope it's a blessing to yours. And so, for a couple minutes while they get ready for our last scene, I felt like this is an important time for me to come. And let me just say this, it could be for you, but this is for me also. I'm gonna sing Made Away by Travis Green.
Standing here, not knowing how we'll get through this test. Holding on to faith you know best. Nothing can catch you by surprise. You've got this figured out and watching us now. When it looks as if we can't win, you wrap us in your arms and step in. Everything we need you supply. You've got this in control, and now we know that you made a way. And when our backs were against the wall, and it looked as if it was over, Lord, you made a way. And now we're standing here only because you made a way.
Has he made a way for anybody?
And now we're here, looking back on where we come from. Because of you and nothing we've done deserve the love and mercy you've shown. and you cause walls to fall, and with your power perform miracles, and there is nothing that's impossible. And Lord, we stand.
I can see it now. purple. I see God. I see God.
And what, silly?
I think I see.
See what?
I'm too old. In fact, I think this is the youngest us ever felt. Dear God, dear stars, dear
and when I finally looked inside. think this is the youngest us ever has.
I had nowhere to go. Lost sight of my the cast of The Color Purple.
We can do better than that. We can give them a standing ovation to the cast of The Color Purple. This is their finale. This was for this particular show. We did all of the seniors. We have some juniors, some sophomores, but y'all come out to the forefront. Let's give a big round of applause for our alumni choir. Recognize the assistant director of theater, Ms. Andrea Nelson. Please step forward. I could have never done this without her. Y'all, please give it up for her. Jessica Potts, please come forward. The director of dance. I cannot dance. I can tell you we're doing it wrong, but I can't dance. She's amazing. To our control room up top, we have Christopher Hasty, and we have Gordon. I don't know Gordon's last name, but yes, they made it happen. To our stage managers. Stage managers, come forth, come forth. I could not have done it without them. And to our dancers, let's give it up for our dancers. I do not want them to feel that it was all about the actors and actresses. It is about everybody. If you close the curtains, I said thank you. If you flipped on the light switch, you are part of the story. And let's give it up for our actors and actresses. I'm gonna hand the mic off to them, but I do wanna say this. Wasn't Kalani Grimes our Celie? Wasn't she amazing? Wasn't she amazing? We have Shanae Saxton come forward as Suge. All right, we have Christian Armand Harrison as Mister. I'm gonna hang. And, oh, come on. We have Keith as Harpo. Then we have Talia Taylor as Sophia. I'm gonna hand the mic off and let them introduce themselves. But I want to definitely introduce the people who are at the forefront and people who weren't at the forefront. But we gotta let them introduce themselves.
My name is Big Day, and I'm Dennis and Curry Doom.
Okay, my name is Chantel, and I am the co-stage director.
My name is Talani Gaines, and I'm the stage director.
My name is Evan Cooper, and I'm tweet.
My name is Bonnie Gaines, and I'm Nettie.
Purple,
and then on the other day I played the other show.
My name is Brandon Williams, and I'm a stage agent.
My name is Leon Jones, and I'm an old mister.
My name is Jonah Dill, and I'm a bastard.
My name is Imani Grissett, and I am one of the squeaks, but today I play Mr. Daughter.
My name is Ron Davis, and I'm a dance actor. Did you join?
My name is Chase Jackson, and I'm a part of Genesis Dance Company.
My name is Devonta Corey, and I'm a part of Genesis Dance Company. I'm so glad you're here. And I want y'all to give it up once off to John Toby, who's my prom day.
My name is Kalani Vision, and I'm part of Genesis Dance Company. Department.
Thank you so much for everybody coming out. If there's a set design person in the building, we want to thank you for blessing us with that set. Thank you so much. We are grateful to you. And let's give it up for our musicians. They helped us out so much tonight. Thank you so much, Blair, Javante, Tim, and a young man on the drums. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. We appreciate you. All of the people that came out, Mr. Mario Williams and the team that came out to give us a nice little cinematographic, all photography, all of that. We want to thank you so much for everything that you've done.
I do. do want to recognize Fred Smith and Garnell and Mary. Can y'all come forward? We definitely want to recognize them. Where are they? Y'all please give it up for them. Let me tell you. We had a groundbreaking here about, y'all can leave if you need to. We had a groundbreaking here about three years ago, and they have been instrumental in helping us get the facilities that we're in today. Please give it up for them. They have been so instrumental in helping us. All right, y'all. Y'all have a good night. Y'all get safe. I hope this play has blessed you all as much as it has blessed me. You all have a great night.
Yeah. All right, Mike. That was
all right. To the parents, thank y'all so much. Thank y'all. Thank y'all for being supportive. Chris over there, thank you for being supportive. And any other parent I may have missed, Christian, our mom's mom. Yes, thank you so much for being here. Thank you. Yep, I recognize it.